Welcome back for the spinning ring part 2. We are going to finish this ring with the spinning part, and it is the rope-like pattern here for the spinning ring. Are you ready? Let's get started. Now it's time to make a spinning part. We want to do the command is called extract isocurve. And we want to extract from this surface right there and right in the middle. Okay, so this is where my spinning ring is going to sit. I need to know what is the circumference of that length, that circle. So that's going to type it length, and it will give me 62.832. So I'm gonna make a straight line. 62.832, and then you type it the number, and then let's go to the top view. You click there, so that is how long that is going to be. I'm going to work on my curve for the pattern and want to turn on the grid snap. So it's gonna go from here to here to here to here. So this is gonna be the pattern that I have. Let me go to use the align tool and align to the center. So that's one of the pattern there. Then I'm going to copy that one to next one. So now I have this pattern right there. That if I'm going to use the sweep to command, I need to have the cross section. So I'm gonna use the arc tool and snapping here to here, and going to the right view and make sure that it's vertical there. Let me do one more time. And to the right view, so that's vertical there. All right, so now we also wanna connect it here to here and here to here. Let's join this one and this one together. So they are two closed curves. Let's go to the surface, sweep two, rail one, rail two, cross section one and two, and you got something like this. Now we have that there, we need to make sure it is solid, so make sure that you cap it. So now double check on your property, it is a closed solid poly surface. Okay, so let's go ahead to look at the top view. Let's make an array all the way to the end. So the command we're going to use is linear array, and we want to array maybe like 65 of them, and we're gonna go from this point to that point. All right, it probably is more than what we need. Let's take a look. Yes, it's almost like we just need to delete three of them. So what we need to do now is to make sure that the end is flat. So that way you are able to have them meet it back together nicely. So on the very last one, I'm going to trim this one off, and then by using the bowling tool. So let's use the bowling difference. This one will be bowling out of this guy. All right, so now we have this. Let's go back to the first one. The first one we need to cut it as well, but I don't want to trim that one. I actually need to make a copy of it. Otherwise it will be too short. Okay, so then I'm going to use the box tool again, and we are going to creating a box like this and a little bit longer, and again we're gonna use the bowling tool, bowling difference that little piece out of this one. Okay, so now you have this. Let's go ahead to let me take a look on this. Maybe I need to make a copy of this one as well and move that little one there. And so let's go ahead to balling all of this. Okay, so let's double check on our top view. Now let's take a look on this one. It's meeting on the left side. That's perfect. And we just need to have it a little bit longer. So on this curve, I want to move this point with the move tool. Let's move it to the edge. If you look at the front view of the bend, you're gonna notice that this is like really sharp point there. It's no way we can cast something like that. So what we like to do is to creating a solid a box underneath it to increasing the thickness a little bit more. All right, so it doesn't have to be more. I have about 0.5 millimeter there. I may want to have roughly about 1 millimeter there, so that way it has some thickness. Then I want to ball in this guy right there. All right, so now our ring is done. It's a closed, solid poly surface. So let me move this curve down a little bit to the bottom of it, so that will fit into it right there. Let's flow this back to the ring. Let's go to the transform. You have flow along the curve. Let's pick up this object to flow. And then we want to pick up the curve right there. Let's move on here to pick up our target curve. All right. So now we have this right there. And let's take a look in the middle. Oh, this is a very good opportunity to show you guys this. We have a perfect fit, and supposedly it should be fit perfectly, but if you look at the red one, it's kind of overlapping a little bit, and I'm not happy with that. So I'm just gonna do one more time. Exactly the same thing. We want to pick up this object, pick up this curve. Before we flow there, rigid copy equals yes, rigid equal no. Do we want to stretch? Yes. Make sure you are stretch equal yes. And then we click on this target curve here. So now if we go back here, you're going to see it's flow really nicely over there. All right. And then that will be our surface. Now when we look at this a little bit, as we say earlier, this is its curve. On the bottom of our ring shank there is flat. It's actually fighting right now on that little corner. Right. So what I wanted to do is enlarge a little bit. One little trick right there. If you send this out for print, it is showing you a closed solid poly surface and everything look nice, but you have the extra surface right there. And that sometimes causes the issue that you don't even know where is it. It's because we flow that, we bend that thing coming back to the circle. There's actually two extra surface right there. All right, to solve this issue, a lot of time, like your computer will tell you everything is perfect, but when you send it for print, when you try to do the STL file, something is not right. I'm going to split this ring by this curve right there. So now I have two of them. Let me go ahead to use the cap to make sure both of them are cap. All right, so now this is a closed poly surface. This is a closed poly surface. And then we're just gonna go ahead to balling unit, those two. Sometimes it will tell you the balling unit fail is because the seam is right at the seam. All right, so what you wanted to do, another little trick is move it just toward that together, 0.001. You cannot even tell by your eye. And then you should be able to balling. All right, so now we have this ring there. We can turn on our basic ring over there, and you can make it bigger if you want to, and you can make it double if you want to. I hope you enjoy the trick that I show you today. If this is your first time here, we'd love to have you subscribe the channel so you will see more tricks and tips that I can show you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next.